वेलकम टू ACF, द ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर गेट एग्रीकल्चर इंजीनियरिंग एंड दिस इज ऑल अबाउट मी. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट द स्पेयर्स. इन प्रीवियस ईयर्स सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस हैज बीन आस्क्ड अपॉन द स्पेयर टॉपिक एंड फ्रेंड्स आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू हैव लिटिल बिट आइडिया रिगार्डिंग द स्पेयर दैट इट इज an equipment which is used for application of chemical in the liquid form. And friends, sometimes the another form of a sprayer which is called duster, and duster is used for application of powders. आपको ये difference याद रखनी है. Sprayers से अपन liquid chemical liquid spray करते हैं and duster से अपन powder form में chemical spray करते हैं. Friends, the motto of both sprayer and duster is same, to kill the harmful microorganisms and kill the weeds. But the ways are different. One is used for powder and another one is used for liquid. And friends, here there are different types of sprayers. I have mentioned total 6 types of sprayers. You have studied for your semester examination also, so a little bit you can get the brief idea about this, because maybe it can ask in one mark question. So you once see, I will not read it one by one. You once pause the video and see. Now friends, the application rate is simply the volume of chemical per hectare. Means in 1 hectare of land, how much volume of chemical required is called the application rate. Application rate हमारा simply होता है कि 1 hectare हमारे पास जमीन है और उसमें अपन कितना chemical डालते हैं, मतलब कितना volume chemical का डालते हैं, उसे अपन simple language में application rate बोलते हैं. And friends, leaf area index is nothing but leaf surface area divided by surface area of field. Friends, I will try to elaborate it in simple language. Suppose that you have 1 hectare of land, and in that 1 hectare of land you have grown the crops, and all the plants have their leaves, and so many leaves are present in each plant. Means I think thousands of millions of leaves are present in 1 hectare of field. And friends, what is the total surface area of all the leaves? Means suppose that 10 million leaves are present in 1 hectare of land. Then what is the total surface area of 10 million leaves divided by the surface area of field? Means surface area of field we have considered that is 1 hectare. And total means how many leaves are present. Total you have to count each and every leaves, and you have to calculate each and every leaves surface area and take the total surface area of each and every leaves and divide it by the total surface area of field. Means if we have considered 1 hectare land, then total surface area of field is 1, and we have to calculate the total surface area of leaves only. So this is LAI, and its range is 0 to 3. Now friends, you see the next term, the field capacity, effective field capacity and actual work rate. Friends, I think all of you have little bit idea of field capacity. This actual work rate is nothing but it is a type of field capacity only. Here in field capacity also, we are doing WS by 10 formula we are using, WS by 10, and whenever efficiency is given, then we multiply it with the efficiency. Means actual field capacity is nothing but actual work rate of a sprayer. Actual field capacity we have calculated by multiplying the theoretical field capacity with its efficiency. So here also we are doing the same thing. And friends, you see the unit, that hectare per hour. If you want to convert it into meter square per second, then you simply put the velocity into meter per second, width into meter, and efficiency into decimal form. Then you can do the unit conversion according to your convenience. So if you want to remember this formula, then you can remember. If you don't want to remember this formula, then also you are not going to lose anything. If you have नॉर्मल कॉमन सेंस एंड नॉर्मल यूनिट डायमेंशन यू नो, देन यू आर वेरी इजिली एबल टू राइट सच टाइप ऑफ फॉर्मूलाज. सो आई हैव रिटन हियर, आई हैव शोन इन दिस स्लाइड ओनली फॉर दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु आर गुड इन रिमेंबरिंग द फॉर्मूलाज. And here also friends, the same thing, if you want to remember the formula then you can remember, if you don't want to remember then also no problem. If you apply the basic concepts of unit dimension then you are able to derive such type of formulas. Here you can see that small q is nozzle flow rate for each nozzle that is in liter per minute. And friends, small q is equal to AVB divided by 60,000. Here A is the application rate, means liter per hectare, V is the velocity and B is the nozzle spacing, and small n is, and large q means total discharge of sprayer. Small q is the discharge of one nozzle. For calculating the total discharge of a sprayer, you have to multiply the small q with the number of nozzles, means n. So large q is equal to small q into n. This is the total discharge of sprayers. Friends, if you are comfortable with remembering formulas, then only you remember. Otherwise, you simply do the unit conversion. I have told you previously also that unit dimensions are very important. So if you are good with unit dimension, then you can easily derive such type of formulas and you can easily solve questions upon this. So you don't have to worry about that you have to remember this formula only. Now friends, the main portion is coming, that is the fundamental relationship in sprayers. Friends, whatever we have studied in fans, means for in pump classes, we have studied some relationship between the discharge, pressure and the diameter. But here in sprayer, it is different from that. So you don't be confused that whatever you have studied in pumps and fans, you simply apply this, that in sprayer. You can't do this mistake. आपको ये गलती नहीं करनी है. हमने जो इस पंप में और फैंस के लिए जो फॉर्मूलेज पढ़े थे, जो रिलेशनशिप पढ़ी थी डिस्चार्ज से प्रेशर की और डायमीटर की, वो हमें यहाँ पे एप्लीकेबल नहीं है. यहाँ पे इसकी दूसरी रिलेशनशिप होती है. सो इसलिए आपको कंफ्यूज नहीं होना है. व्हेन एवर द क्वेश्चंस हैज बीन आस्क्ड अपॉन द स्प्रेयर, देन यू हैव टू अप्लाई द स्प्रेयर्स रिलेशनशिप. एंड व्हेन एवर द क्वेश्चंस आस्क्ड अपॉन द पंप और फैंस, देन यू हैव टू अप्लाई दोज रिलेशनशिप. So the first one, you see, discharge is directly proportional to root under P. P is the pressure, means discharge is directly proportional to root under pressure. From here you can derive that pressure is directly proportional to discharge square, means P is directly proportional to Q square. If you are squaring both the side, then you can get P is directly proportional to Q square. And friends, for diameter it is very important, you remember it very carefully. For diameter is inversely proportional to P to the power 1/3, means the diameter is inversely proportional to P to the power, means pressure to the power 1/3. आपको ये relation अच्छे से याद रखनी है कि जो हमारा diameter होता है वो 1/3 रूट अंडर पी टू द पावर 1/3 होता है. ये रिलेशनशिप होती है डायमीटर की प्रेशर के साथ, जबकि हमारा वो पंप के केस में वो दूसरी रिलेशनशिप होती है. पंप के केस में सिंपल डायमीटर इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू रूट अंडर पी होता है, बट हियर इट इज डिफरेंट. सो यू हैव टू टेक केयर अबाउट दिस. नाउ फ्रेंड्स, यू सी हियर द यूनिफॉर्मिटी ऑफ एप्लीकेशन. फ्रेंड्स, हियर you have to see only the basic trigonometry. I think all of you have studied the trigonometry in your intermediate classes. So friends, you can see here the spray angle. Friends, when I am studying, many times I have done mistakes upon the spray angle only. So many times I have considered theta by 2 and theta, many times I am little bit confused in this. So you see it very carefully that spray angle is simply the total theta, means when we are doing, you can see here the tan theta relation. Tan theta by 2 is equal to d by 2 divided by h, where d is the diameter. Here you can see that the circular portion you see here, when the sprayer is moving and when it is blowing the air, blowing the water, means when water is coming out, it will comes out in circular shape. So it has some diameter d. So this diameter d, and here b is the simply the spacing between two nozzles. Suppose a sprayer is moving, it has 7 to 8 nozzles like that, and b is the spacing between the two nozzles, two successive nozzles. And the, whatever the liquid is coming out of the nozzle is coming in form of a circle. Whenever you have seen that water is coming out of the pipe, then it is coming out in form of a circle, means circular shape, which has the diameter d. So, and the height of a sprayer boom is h. So you can simply use the basic trigonometry, that is tan theta by 2. Friends, you remember that spray angle is tan theta, spray angle is theta, and we are considering here tan theta by 2, means half of the spray angle. Tan theta by 2 is equal to d by 2 divided by h. So this is the very basic and very simple relationship which you have to consider always. Means जो हमारा है स्प्रे एंगल होता है थीटा, जो क्वेश्चन में दिया हुआ होगा उसका अपने को पहले हाफ करना है. थीटा बाई टू मीन्स टेन थीटा बाई टू इज इक्वल टू डी बाई टू डिवाइडेड बाई एच, वेर एच इज द हाइट ऑफ स्प्रे बूम एंड डी इज द डायमीटर ऑफ स्प्रे पैटर्न और डायमीटर ऑफ द लिक्विड कमिंग आउट ऑफ द स्प्रेयर. रिमेंबर दिस बेसिक ज्योमेट्री. व्हेनेवर यू सी द क्वेश्चंस, the first thing you should do that you draw the geometry, draw this diagram, because when you draw this diagram then 50% of the question you can solve, because you can easily get the idea where is the overlap, what is the height, what is the diameter, what is the spacing, everything are going to be clear. I will show you the questions. Friends, this is GATE previous year question. Sorry, I have not marked the year, but this is GATE previous year question. You can see here that spray angle is given 75 degree and it is asking to calculate the height of a spray boom, means hame h calculate karna, and deposit level is 30% greater than the nozzle spacing, and nozzle spacing is 40 cm. Friends, here you can see that I have drawn the diagram, because when you draw the diagram then everything are going to be clear to you. Spacing is 40 cm, so half of the spacing is 20 cm. And friends, you can see that it is saying that 30% is more, means 30% of greater than the nozzle spacing. Here you can see that in the question it is given 30% greater than the nozzle spacing. So nozzle spacing is 40, so 30% more is equal to 1.3, means 100 plus 30% means 1.3. So you can get the diameter of spray pattern, that is 52 cm. And friends, after this you can see here I have drawn the half of the 52 is 26. So I have drawn here the each and everything very carefully. Here you can see that 20 cm is the half of the nozzle spacing, and 26 cm is the radius or diameter by 2, half of the diameter of spray pattern. Now friends, the question is going to be very easy, and here you can see that spray angle is also given 37.5, means spray angle is 75 degree, so half of 75 is 37.5 degree. Now friends, things are easy. You can simply apply tan theta by 2 is equal to 6 by h dash. Friends, you see there are two ways to solve this question. The first way it has solved, and the you can see the easiest way I have solved in here. You can see that another way I have written here. In this way friends, simply you have calculated the 26 cm is total from A to B, the distance is 26 cm, and we have to calculate the h, you can see that small h we have to calculate, means height of whom it is asking to calculate. So small h it is saying to calculate. So you simply apply 1037.5 is equal to 26 by h. Here you can see that 26 by, sorry, I have written this capital H, but you don't have to worry about that. You can see that 26 by capital H is equal to 1037.5. So simply capital H you can calculate, 26 by 1037.5, that is 33.88 centimeter. And friends, here the second way also, by considering the equilateral triangle OAB and triangle BCD, means here we are in second way, we are doing simply taking these small triangles, and after this we are taking the similarity of both the small triangles with the large triangle. So that way also you can calculate, and this easy way also you can calculate, whatever way you want to calculate in the examination, both ways are open for you. So you understand both the ways of solving the question, that is important for me, because if you understand, then you can easily solve in the question. Now friends, you see the next question. Here it is saying that 20 hollow cone nozzles to achieve application rate of 200 liters per, this question that rate of 200 liters per hectare, and the calibration test nozzle flow rate was 1.25 liters per minute, and the rated nozzle flow rate is 0.473 liters per minute and available at 275 kilopascal. And in the first part it is saying that if the medium diameter is 200 micron at 1 megapascal, then calculate the drop size at the desired flow rate. Friends, in this question that the flow rate at 275 kilopascal is 0.473, and the flow rate 1.25 is the nozzle flow rate, and the pressure is not given at this flow rate. And friends, it is asking what is the droplet size at the desired flow rate, means at this flow rate what is the size of droplet. So the first thing you should do here, that you calculate the pressure at the desired flow rate, means how much amount of pressure is present when the sprayer is discharging at a rate of 1.25 liters per minute. So friends, all of you know the relationship, Q is equal to root under of pressure. So Q1 Q2 is equal to root under P1 by P2. So simply you can calculate the P2 value. Now friends, you have calculated the P2, and P2 means you have calculated the pressure at the desired flow rate, means you can see here in the question the desired flow rate is 1.25 liters per minute, and you have calculated the pressure 1920.57 kilopascal at this flow rate. Means now we have to calculate the droplet size at this pressure, means at desired flow rate. And here in the question it is given that 200 micron is at 1 megapascal. So you simply apply the logic of diameter and pressure relationship. Friends, all of you know that diameter is proportional to 1 by pressure to the power 1 by 3. Means cube root, 1 by cube root of the pressure. Diameter is proportional to 1 by pressure to the power 1 by 3. So this is the simple relationship. So phi 1 by phi 2, phi I have represented the diameter with phi. So phi 1 by phi 2 is equal to P2 by P1 to the power 1 by 3. So you can put all these values except phi 2 value, because 200 micron is given and 1 megapascal is given. So convert the 1 megapascal into kilopascal, so multiply with 1000, and friends you can calculate the phi 2, that is 160 micron. And in the second part it is saying that calculate the field capacity. Friends, it is very easy to calculate the field capacity, because the velocity is given, and it is also given that 20 hollow nozzles are present. So friends, 20 hollow nozzles इट हैज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन एंड द फेलोशिप. फ्रेंड्स दिस ऑल क्वेश्चंस एंड कॉन्सेप्ट्स आई हैव डील विद द फॉर्मेशन इंग्लिश सेक्शन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड ऑल आर आस्क्ड इन द प्रीवियस ईयर गेट क्वेश्चंस एंड दिस ऑल यू हैव टू बी मास्टर्ड इन दिस टॉपिक्स देन ओनली यू आर एबल टू क्रैक द गेट एग्जामिनेशन विद इन टॉप 10 और टॉप 5 रैंक बिकॉज these days so much competition is rising so you should be very clear with your concepts and friends my motto of making video on pharmacy is to remove the fear of pharmacy because most of the students I have seen that they are feeling means panic and feeling uncomfortable with the pharmacy section they can do well in the other sections but in pharmacy they are facing so much difficulties they can't get the confidence to solve the questions. So my main motto of dealing with pharmacy is that only to remove the fear from your mind and from your concepts that you can easily excel the examination in the better way. So subscribe our channel and share to all the GATE aspirants.